In this video, I'm going to show you how to create the neon text effect in Photoshop. I'm going to show you how to use layer styles to create a neon sign text effect just like this. And then I'm going to show you how to change the color of the neon sign by using an adjustment layer. So we're going to start off by choosing our font. I'm going to go over here in the toolbar and get my text tool. Click on T, and I'm going to use Proxima Nova Regular. I'm going to link some other fonts that I found that you may be interested in using, but you can use your own font. I think something that is a little wide to begin with is good to start with. So I'm just going to click in all caps, Las Vegas. Click the check mark to commit it. I'm going to say Command T. I'm going to hold my Shift and Option key, and this is going to scale this out. And let's make it about this big. And I'm going to click the check mark to commit it. So usually you see a neon sign on a dark wall. If you want this background, I'll also link to it in the description. If I want to center this, I will say Command A and come up here and select my Move tool. And I can use any of these tools to center my text and say Command D. Now what we're going to use are the styles, or if you double click on this layer that says Las Vegas, here is the layer style dialog. I'm going to say cancel for now, and to make this as easy as possible, which is the goal, we're going to use some styles that are in Photoshop. If you don't see styles over here in one of the panels, you come up here to Window, click on that, and come down here to Styles. And you have all these different styles here. One we're going to use, it's actually in Legacy Styles and More. And if you don't see that, you can come over here to this flyout menu and click on that. And you can come here to Legacy Styles and More. Click on that. I don't need the extra one. And in Legacy Styles and More, twirl that down and come all the way down to where you see something called Web Styles. Twirl that down, and we're going to select one of these styles just as a starting point to make this go a little bit quicker. So you have all these different styles here. Purple gel, red gel, yellow gel, green gel. We're going to go with purple gel, and I'm going to click on that. And right away, that style was applied to the Las Vegas layer right here. So this will be our starting point. If you double click on the layer, with the layer styles panel, here you're going to see all the effects that it took to make up this style. You can deselect any of these styles or make adjustments right here to the way it looks. So to use all the styles in this layer style dialog, you come over here to where it says Blending Options. Now for our purposes, we don't need to use all of these styles that are here now. We're not going to use Bevel Emboss, we're not going to use Contour, Inner Shadow, Satin, Color Overlay, or Dropped Shadow. This is just a starting point, and we're going to make this a lot simpler. So the first one we're going to select is Inner Glow. You want to set the Blend Mode here to Hard Light. The opacity right here, you want to make it 40, and size, you want to make this 12. And this color square right here sets the glow color. I want to double click on that. With this color picker up, you want to come down here and you want to type in 7200 FF and say OK. So that's going to be our glow color. So now we're going to come to the outer glow and select that. In this blend mode, we are going to set to Linear Dodge, and the opacity, I'm going to change this to 80, and down in the section where it says Elements, we're going to change the size to 70, and for Auto Glow, we're going to change the color slightly. Click on the color box, and with the color picker up, type in 9600 FF, and say OK. And we're still on Outer Glow. Click on this contour picture right here. And in the middle of this line, we're going to put a point. Click on the graph right there in the middle. I'm going to set this point, and we're going to set the input to 48 and the output to 62. And this just gives us a nice curve and makes the neon light a little more brighter. And I'm going to say OK and close the layer style. So now with the text layer selected, I'm going to say Command or Control J and duplicate it. This bottom layer here is the copy. So if it made another layer called Las Vegas copy, you want to put it below the first text layer. So if you double click on the duplicated layer, it brings up the layer style dialog. And for this one, we're not going to need inner glow, so you can untick that. But what we need to add is a stroke. So if you come down here and where it says FX, select that, and you can select stroke. Put stroke selected. You want to make sure that your size is at 1 pixel. Your position is inside. Opacity is 100. And this color is completely black. So what this is going to do is it's going to make the edges soft again, because sometimes they can look a little bit pixelated. And this just helps. And you can leave the blend mode to normal. Next, we need to highlight the outer glow. We're going to leave the blend mode to linear dodge. Down here in the elements, we're going to set the size to its maximum of 250. And we're going to come down here to contour again and adjust this line. We can add a point right about here. And we're going to make this input 11 and the output 28. Click on the middle point, and we're going to make the input 34 and the output 65. And then we're going to make another point about here on this graph, and we're going to make this input 76 and our output 94. And this gives us a nice curve. I'm going to say OK, and we'll say OK here again. If you're getting value out of this so far, hit that like button and consider subscribing. Now the last touch we're going to do is we're going to add a new layer. Come down here to the create new layer icon, and I want this layer below everything. So it's below the two text layers. I'm going to close this group so you can see better. So there's the two text layers and a new blank layer below all of them and in between the background. I'm going to hit B for the brush tool. And I have the brush hardness set to 0%. And the size of the brush is going to be about 390 pixels. And in the color swatch over here, I want the color to be 7200FF. And that's the color I'm going to paint with. And we're going to give this an extra glow. So with the new layer that we created, I'm just going to paint over this like so, just the outline. And paint over it something like this. And then we're going to change the blend mode of that layer we just painted on down here to soft light. So we've added a little bit more glow there. Now a quick way to change the color, if you really want to change it and change it slightly, if you come down here to your layers panel and add a hue and saturation adjustment layer. And then what you could do is you can change the hue just to see if there's something else that you like. But that's what we first came up with. And you can see all the effects that you added over here. If you drop this down, you can see that they're all here on both of them. And if you wanted to add another word and you wanted it to look the same, you would add your text and size it to the way you wanted. And you would have to duplicate it and copy the same effects from the layers you already created. Like for instance, this was the top layer. If I hold Alt and drag it up to this top layer, and then come down here to the copy, hold Alt and drag it to the bottom layer here, that's the way that you would add another word and copy the same effects to that word. If you want more tutorials like this, click or tap on one of the videos on the screen now. Please like, share, and subscribe to this video. And remember, it's never too late to learn. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.